good morning, everyone. I'm just on my way to school,
and I will talk to you after that,
because I'm running a little late again. Yeah, reoccurring theme nowadays, me running late. My crutches really slow me down in the mornings. Plus, I'm not a morning person at all.
November. For $2 a pluck, you get to pull a hair out of the mustache. Keep it for your very own. Maybe even clone it, make another me.
Or think about it. That's what I would do.
Or clone it, make another me. Just think, you could have another me around.
If you don't want to hurt it.
Make sure you twist.
Right above the lip is not good either.
Yeah, no. In like the corners of the lips, the side stuff isn't so bad.
I don't really want to be.
Yeah, but does everybody else want you to be?
Be mean.
Be mean.
That's what I do. Okay, ready?
Same thing. We're gonna close my eyes and then we'll walk back. Ah! Stop it.
Okay. Ready? Are you ready?
Yeah.
Say yes. Ready? 3, 1.
That space there,
and
then I
said
it.
Oh, it's
like she's prolonging it.
Yay! Hi, so I just walked by a group. They were kind of like middle-aged people or whatever. Anyways, but they made me realize when I'm older, I want to be like one of those crazy old people that like embarrasses their kids, but not like in a mean way, and that, I don't know, I just want to have fun. I don't want to get old and boring, and I want to always have fun and enjoy my life.
It's after school now, and as you might see from the video where I was plucking a teacher's mustache for Movember, I was thinking about Nick, who also has a mustache.
I do.
And I was wondering how much he would pay, or he would take, for me to be able to pluck his mustache. Like, I've honestly been thinking about this all day, and I've been really excited, because would you accept $100?
Yeah.
Yeah? Well, I'm not gonna actually do it, I was just curious.
Oh.
So, I am waiting while Nick's in his physio, and I just got a text from him. Apparently, he thought it was Thursday, and like today's Wednesday. And now I'm gonna go to the library and I'm gonna do some homework. Okay, so I'm at the library right now. I don't know if you can hear me because I'm trying to whisper because I'm supposed to be quiet in the library. And I'm doing homework. I'm studying like on the Indians and Widows. And I don't know, I just like walking, so I wanted to go to the thing. I don't know. It's not that interesting. It's not the whole deal either. Bye.
Alright, so I thought it was Thursday today, I have a physio appointment on Thursday.
What day is it actually?
It's Wednesday, but I showed up anyway.
Doors over this way.
I showed up today, and it's only Wednesday, but they put me in anyway, and I canceled my appointment for tomorrow, because I thought it was Thursday, and it's really Wednesday, and I'm kind of quite distraught. I'm rattled.
Good.
I've been living
whole
this
week thrown off, so tomorrow's not Friday.
Unfortunately. Tomorrow is Thursday. And I have a dentist appointment in like
now.
An hour.
Actually, on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not Thursday. Which is today. Not Thursday. If so, I would have missed my appointment for my dentist. Which would have been awkward. Also, Melissa's convinced that I should let her open her Christmas gift.
Okay.
It's the 30th of November.
I was just talking to somebody, and he let his boyfriend open his Christmas gift so he didn't have to put up with him whining for the next 2 months, and I think that's a great idea for Nick.
I can handle it.
No, you can't. I can be really, really annoying. You don't even understand how annoying. And I don't think he'll be able to handle it.
All right,
okay.
Near-death experience.
Traumatic. I just put my head down as we were walking in the car. We were like a parking spot away from the car in a very on-busy parking lot.
Yeah, like it's literally like not busy, like there's like three cars.
You can't see it's
working. You can't really see. There's like one car there. And see, look at all that empty space. And then out of nowhere, this car just comes barreling through.
Well, I thought it was like on the other side of the parking
lot. Yeah, it just comes barreling through and almost hits me and I'm on crutches.
It was like this close and
why are you going like 50 kilometers an hour in
it
a
was
parking
fast
lot?
For that.
Okay, it's like 70 kilometers in a parking lot. Not needed. It's a parking lot. There's nobody here.
It's like the
you don't need to go that fast.
Our attraction for people to try to hurt Nick is what
people,
it seems
people
like.
Just want to like
hurt
smoke
the guy
into
crush.
Me. They want to hurt me. I don't like people.
Kidding, I don't like certain people that try to hit me with their cars. Not sure if you can see me or not. I just ran to the car because it is pouring outside. Like, it's actually pouring. And it wasn't raining earlier, so I'm not wearing a raincoat. But, I mean, the rain is just teeming down. And I had to use my crutches and crutch from the front entrance to my car in the rain. And also, I don't know if you can see this or not, I'm gonna roll down the window. Oh, the rain's pouring in. Okay. So, there's this power line right there. And it fell down. So, I'm not quite sure if I can get through or not. So, I might have to wait here. Look, I can put you guys outside because it's a waterproof camera. Oh, it's all inside now. I don't like the dentist. I just thought I would let you guys know that. I really, really just hate dentists. Oh, just the sound of the tools in your mouth and stuff. Generally, just don't like people, like, with tools near my face. It's just one of those things. Anybody can relate to that? I think so. I might be hanging out with Marissa later tonight. If so, you'll see some clips of us together. Tonight she's actually going to be participating in the Vow of Silence for Free the Children. So if we do hang out, she's gonna basically be silent the whole video. And I just wanted to explain that to you. I was going to do it and I forgot this morning. I'm a very horrible person, guys. Very horrible person. Now, I just forgot completely about it. And I was gonna do a whole silent vlog where I just didn't talk. So I'm just gonna not talk right now. I'm gonna send a big shout out to Becca. You're amazing. What you're doing, she did the Fow Science all day today. So from 12 o'clock last night, midnight, she was completely silent. She turned her phone off. She didn't Facebook, didn't Twitter. She cut all that out of the day. Even throughout school, she did not say a word. So, it's a really great cause, and if any of you know about it or participated in it, congratulations. You've done a really great thing. Yeah, so thanks for everybody that does that, those type of things. It's really, I don't know how to say, it's just really rewarding when you decide that you're going to help other people out in different types of ways. And I really just wanted to send a big shout out to Becca for participating today and staying silent and actually sticking to the vow. Yeah. It's like a monsoon outside, and this all came out of nowhere because about an hour ago it was completely bone dry outside. It was just a little cloudy, and now look at it, it's just pouring.
Okay, I just want to say goodnight.